Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to iTutor Therapy, back with another video. This is Teacher Adele, and today we're gonna talk about one of those weird things that can happen in the classroom when a student is very confident and very good, but they're actually taking over the class and not giving the other students the time or the chance to talk and express themselves. Now, this can lead to a very big problem on your hand, because if you don't handle this situation, other students might complain about it, might give you a low rating for not giving them enough time or enough opportunities to speak and express themselves. And if you shush that guy in the wrong way, they also might give you a bad rating because you might don't give them the chance that they need or they want to express themselves and you stop them. So we're gonna learn how to handle this situation while keeping everyone happy and avoiding those low rating. Let's begin. So the first thing that we need to know or look at is who we're talking to, who we are dealing with in that situation. Is it a high-level student, a low-level student, a junior, or an adult? Because all these things are going to factor in the decision you're making in order to handle that situation without getting any damage. So the first thing we're going to look at if it was a high-level adult. And in that case, your job is pretty easy. You can just politely ask them to give the other student a chance or something like, oh yeah, thank you so much, but now let's listen from the other one. And he's going to understand. It's not going to be a problem. The problem is when you have a low-level student who just doesn't want to stop. And in here, I recommend that you actually, if he's a student and a kid and he just talks all the time, you can turn off his microphone because he will answer all the questions. In his turn, turn the microphone on. When it's not his turn anymore, just turn her microphone off and continue with the other students, talking to them and dealing with them. Now, if the student continues to turn his microphone back on, this can be very annoying and it can be a big problem. However, if you turn the microphone back off multiple times and message them a small message in the chat box to please keep the microphone turned off, they will understand most of the time. You can even call IT and tell them that there is a noisy background from this particular student and they're gonna try to contact them and tell them to keep the microphone turned off unless the teacher turns it on himself. When we are telling those people to stop talking or to give a chance to the other people, we don't want it to sound like I am shushing him. I'm like, okay, please, just please. Now let's listen from the others. It's not good like that. What we wanna do here is thank them and compliment them. It's like, oh my God, you are so good. Thank you so much. I really love that. And then let's listen from the other one. So do it in a cheerful and happy way in order to not make the student, whether it was an adult or a junior, feel like you are shushing them or telling them to stop talking. Just compliment them, thank them for what they said, and then pull back and direct their attention to the other student and tell them, yeah, thank you. Now let's talk here. And they usually understand that and appreciate what you're saying to, what trying to say and do, and it works. Another one is, if you want all the students to get an equal speaking time and one of them is trying to take over, that means he likes to talk. That means he likes to read. Have him read more than the others. They won't mind it. That means also you can also try with him to tell them, okay, you read the question and they will answer. He will feel like he participated, but because he's reading the question, he understands that he has to shut up and wait for them to answer. And that way you are involving two students at the same time, which is very good for you. You just sit back and relax and manage this process and everyone is happy and feel like they are participating. So to recap everything that we might want to do if there is a student trying to take over, the first thing is try to talk to him and ask him nicely. The second thing is try to use his enthusiasm to run the class in a different way. For example, make him read the questions and the other students answer, or make him have a conversation with the other students so they will feel like they're contributing and he's still contributing. No one is getting shushed. No one is told to shut up. The third thing is, if he's a child, he's just crazy all over the place, turn off the microphone. And if he turns it back on, you can always try to message him and call IT about a noisy background and they can contact them in a Chinese message, which will tell the student to try to keep the microphone off unless you turn it on yourself. Now, the important thing is, while you're doing all this, the important thing is to not lose your cool. to start to keep your smile, to be positive, to be happy and friendly, even if it was very annoying for you. Because once you become not happy or not friendly, you are risking yourself getting a low rating because you're not friendly or you did something wrong. And it's just, there will always be on the client's side if there was a complaint against you. There will always be someone on the client's side and no one is gonna take your side. So try to make yourself immune to all that and avoid all these mistakes completely. The smile should never leave your face. The friendliness should never be out of the tone of your voice. Should always be friendly. You should never talk in an annoyed or an irritated way. And if there is a very major problem, just turn off the microphone and call IT, and they will always be able to help you with that. That's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. That was a quick video about one of the first requests that I got on Facebook, and I'm gonna do for the rest of the week and the other week as well. All the requests that you guys ask for me, stay tuned every Sunday, Tuesday, and Thursday for more awesome videos. Thank you so much for watching, and peace.